I'm Simon, and I'm here at AirBeamTV to get you started mirroring your Mac to your Sharp smart TV. So let's get into it. First things first, we need to download the AirBeamTV app to our Mac. So to do this, we head to the AirBeamTV website. We then click Mac from the top menu, and then we click download the app, which will scroll us down to our list of TV brands where we can find Sharp. Click on Sharp, and that'll take us to the download page. Hot tip, download the trial first to check it works for what you need. So let's do that now. Click download the trial, and that will download the app to our desktop. I'll save that where I can remember. Downloads very quickly, small app, and then we will just install that like we would any other Mac app. So I will open the file, and then all you need to do is drag it across into your applications folder, and that is installed. It's worth noting that we are using a regular Sharp Smart TV, but your Sharp Smart TV might be running the Android TV or the Roku operating system. In this case, you'll need to download a receiver app to the TV for the best performance. Luckily, the AirBeamTV app will guide you through that process as well. So once we've installed the app to our Mac, we need to go ahead and open it up for the first time. So I'll click to open the app, and it will say, do I want to open an app from the internet? Yes, I do. That's where I got it from. And once it's open, it will pop up in our taskbar at the top. Click the menu bar icon to get started. So let's do that now. The first thing it'll ask us to do is install the audio driver. What this means is we need to install a tiny bit of software that allows the sound to travel from our Mac to the TV. The AirBeamTV app will talk us through that, so I'll click install. And then there's a little installer that pops up, which will talk us through installing the whole thing. Very simple. You can probably do something else for a minute. And it's installed. So now that that's done, we go back to the taskbar and click on the AirBeamTV icon. We can now click the checkbox that says enable sound on TV. This will give us a little pop-up that says allow access to microphone. Again, that's so that we can get the sound from our Mac to the TV itself. So I will click authorize, and then I will click OK. Next up, I will click the scale display to fit the TV screen checkbox. That just means it'll stretch it out so it takes up the whole screen. Looks much nicer. And almost ready to start mirroring. All that I need to do is check this box at the top that says target device. Now, my TV should be displayed in there because we are connected to the same network using our Mac and our TV. Ideally, you'll connect the TV to your network via a wired cable for the best performance. So in my drop-down TV box there, it says Sharp UHD TV, that's this guy, which means we're on the same network, which means it's time to click start mirroring. Now there'll be a little delay between things happening on this screen and that screen. It's called latency. It should be 1 to 3 seconds. So it's not gonna be a problem if you're looking at photos or videos. What it does mean is that you can't do high intensity gaming. Sorry about that. And there we go. That's my Mac screen mirrored onto the big screen. So what might you want to use this for? Well, maybe you want to show off some photos you've taken. You've got back from a vacation, or maybe you've just got a brand new tiny dog and you want to show your entire family as big as possible. We hit it to full screen.
Oh, look at her little face.
Perhaps you've got a presentation stored on your Mac and you want to display it on a bigger screen in the office or at an event. Perfect. Get it up on the screen here. Again, chuck it into full screen and look at this. We've got the whole thing there, the Gantt chart. I definitely know what that is. And finally, perhaps you want to watch videos on a big screen that's bigger than your Mac screen. Well, thanks to the audio driver that we installed, you can do that very easily. So you just play a video on this screen, pop it into full screen, turn the volume up on here, And the volume's coming out of the TV. Wonderful. I'll turn that down before the neighbors get annoyed. And that is how easy it is. If you do have any questions or queries or problems, feel free to get in touch via Facebook Messenger or good old-fashioned email. In the meantime, write it on a chalkboard 100 times like the beginning of The Simpsons. Happy mirroring.